Hey everyone, blessed be. Just coming back with another update. Yesterday was Pagan Pride Day in New York City. There was a festival held at Washington Square Park. So I took a trip down there and I recorded some footage. I posted that early this morning or last night overnight. So it's up on my page now if you want to watch it. I apologize for the rectangular viewing because I used an iPhone and forgot to hold it the long way. So I had to flip the footage, and it's it has two black panels at the side, but you can still see everything that's going on. I edited that and I put it together because I promised you guys footage from there. It was pretty nice. I just want to come back to you today, since I got in late last night, I didn't have enough time to make a video, so I wanted to come back today to show you guys what I purchased while at the festival. The festival was great. This wasn't my first time going. I've gone twice before. This time, there were some of the same vendors, but I found a lot more stuff. I found a lot more new items and things like that. So I purchased some things, and there was also a performance by SJ Tucker. She was performing with a band of drummers. There was also a ceremony that for the harvest, the harvest ceremony, honoring deity, honoring the ancestor, honoring Mother Nature, and I partook in the ceremony. That ceremony was actually I liked it. It was nice and interesting. There was a lot of pantheons that were prayed to, including the ancestors of deity, and there was a spiral dance that we did. So all that great stuff is in the video titled Pagan Pride Day Festival. Okay, I think that's the title of the video. Yeah, so let me just show you guys what I got. And I have a few other things here that didn't come from Pagan Pride Day that I want to show you guys also. But I mostly got pieces to wear. Previously I bought oil. They sell everything. They sell oils, incense, herbs, they sell clothing, accessories. I stuck with accessories and I got some jewelry. Actually, the first thing I purchased was a pendulum. So I've wanted a pendulum for some quite some time. And I would find that doing my tarot card readings, I do it mostly for friends, but usually I'm asked, or because the tarot card readings is just a logical overview of the situation. You can't really give them yes or no answers. And sometimes I am asked by, there's a knot in my chain. I'll try to get that out later. But sometimes I'm asked by my querents, can I have a more yes or no answer? And I always say, oh, I wish I had a pendulum for that. It's amethyst. It has a little ball of amethyst here at the bottom, at the top, and then it goes down like that. Okay, so that was a pendulum I purchased. This was $15. The vendor sold it for $15, and I think that's probably what you would find it for online, so not bad. It wasn't a bad price. And the second thing I purchased was a pentacle. Now, I don't own a pentacle. Actually, I do own a pentacle, but I don't wear it. I'll show you it. This is a pentacle I own that I bought from the Lord's Union. I think it's made from soapstone. But I like it. I mean, you could definitely rock with it like a hippie outfit or something like that. But I just find it kind of clunky, so I don't wear this. It's handmade in the vendor. I should put a little eye in the front. And it's on a cord. So I wanted something that was more for everyday wear. and I'm not really decided what I'm going to do with this, if I'm going to keep it or give it away or what, but. So I spotted this one. This is handcrafted jewelry from DragonKingdoms.com. They had a tint there. And this pentacle drew my eye. And I've had the means to purchase a pentacle. I've just never done it because I've never found one that really spoke to me. But when I saw this, I just said, you know, I just knew that this was my pentacle. So it is a sterling silver Celtic moon pentagram. It is decorated with amethyst. It says, and I'll just take it out. It was $40. Actually, my boyfriend actually purchased this one for me. Out of the kindness of his heart. Bag, but this is how it came. It was in a bag. Like that. And this is the card on it, and it says, "Amethyst is the stone of spirituality and contentment, and also the stone of meditation. It balances energy, cleans the aura, and bestows stability, protection, strength, invigoration, and peace. Amethyst increases the activity in the right brain, cuts through illusion, and helps to develop a psychic ability. Store a small piece of amethyst with your tarot cards or runes to keep the power of divination to time." So I'm very drawn to amethyst, and I love the fact that it's grounding. I love the color. I love purple. And that it opens the third eye and your psychic awareness, which are all things that I'm very much interested in because I do psychic work and medium work. So I found this pentacle to be perfect because it has amethyst on it. Amethyst beads here. So I'll show you guys what it looks like. And it's decorated with the amethyst beads. And sorry. There you go. And there is the moon and if I wear it on the board, it just looks like a if they had anything to say about it, I'd just say, hey, it's a more star. It is what it is. Okay. The last item I purchased. This item called to me, and they gave it to me in this bag here. Really pretty charms there, locket charms, so much neat stuff. This is a clasp, which I was told by the vendor is a clasp that they would use for pearl keys or pearl necklaces. In case the necklace ever came in clasp, it would still stay around for that. As you can see, the clasp holder. So you basically just squeeze it like this, and it pulls out. And this is on a brass chain. The keys, brass too. The magnesium and iron deposits are what cause those patterns in the stone. So this is an agate stone, which is very good for grounding. I find it's beautiful. It makes sense that they put a key on the end. Keys are usually symbolic of unlocking. I also think keys would be symbolic of protection. So the agate stone has the properties of grounding, of centering, of protecting. It has the property of opening yourself up, giving yourself strength and stamina, kind of like God energies. You like push forward. It has the properties of just making you more aware. So in essence, it has the properties of opening up doors and just, you know, helping you push you to another level. So I thought that made perfect sense just to look it up. So that's my necklace. I love it. I really, really love this. It looks very antique. Corvus Creations, and they have an Etsy shop. So Corvus Creations. Okay. So those were my purchases from Pagan Pride Day. And I'll show you what else I got. Now this my boyfriend got me. I'll show it to you. Little bowl. Looks like a bear on top. I'm gonna say it's a bear. He went to he lives out in Connecticut, and he went to a festival there. And a fair there, and he said there was a native man there, Native American. And he was selling items, and he picked up this bowl for me because he thought that I'd like it, which I do. I'm going to, right now it's on my bookshelf altar. I'm going to put it on my new altar once that comes in. And most likely I'll use it as some type of orphan bowl. Yeah, that's nice. I thought that was a neat find, and it has an initial on the bottom. Okay, so see what that guy's name. Okay. Handcrafted from clay. So after Pagan Pride Day, we took a walk to Barnes & Noble, and I picked up two books there that I'm going to show you guys. The first one, not really pagan-y, this has more to do with other things that I'm interested in. I'll just show you what it says. Cults, conspiracies, and secret societies. The straight of Freemasons, Illuminati, Skull and Bones, Black Helicopters, New World Order. And it is by author Goldbag, and it just contains information on all that stuff. And that is one of my areas of interest that I'm very into studying about and looking into. And in the future, you will probably see a few videos on my page addressing this that are not in my Wicca spirituality, mysticism, but they do utilize the craft, guys, so, yeah. This other book is more of a research book. It is The Mandala of Discovering the Power of the Uranus by Richard Morris Ponte. And it says here, Richard Morris is one of the most important teachers of transformational knowledge. The Mandala of Uranus shows us why and how we habitually obstruct our innate potential for what Richard Morris calls radical aliveness, a life of authenticity, overflowing energy, and joy. In these pages, Richard Morris gives us an effective practice that is readily incorporated into day-to-day life. It illustrates that there are, in fact, only four places our minds ever go when we leave the now, the past, the present, the future, judgments of ourselves, judgments of others. It allows us to trace precisely the path we have taken away from most authentic and essential being whenever we are not fully present, and simultaneously shows us the way home. Drawing from this profound self-realization and more than three decades of working with people of diverse backgrounds, Richard Morris accompanies and encourages the reader on a journey towards freedom from fear and other limiting or threatening feelings. Deep self-understanding, inner ease, spontaneous healing, more fulfilling relationships, and enhanced creativity are all wonderful lessons. Now, this book was $16.95. This one's $60. I'm really looking forward to getting into this, and if I find any other great stuff, I will share it with you guys. Oh yeah, so that is everything that I purchased. Thank you guys for watching. I did promise a video with my friends from the SBAT doing a ritual, but that actually did not pan out because of some situations that arose. So hopefully I'll be able to record some other footage. Me and my friend are actually going to take a trip to go do some other spiritual work with another friend. So like, it will be a very sacred ritual, so I cannot divulge that ritual because it's a private ritual for the friends. But before we go, maybe we can check in with you guys. Or I can just check back in with you guys and tell you how that went. And if I learn anything during that process, because it is it is involving media work. So I've been doing a lot with that. So I do want to come back to you with some more information on that the further I go in my practice with that, because I am doing work and opening up those things within me. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time, peace and blessings.